This video demonstrates the basics of Google Slides. After watching this video, you should be able to create a basic slides presentation, add collaborators, add text boxes and images, adjust formatting, and share your slides with whomever you choose. You can create a Google Slides presentation in two places. One option is to create a blank slide deck from within your Google Drive. To do this, sign into your Google account and navigate to Google Drive. Locate and select the New button on the top left side of the Drive interface. Then select Slides from the dropdown that appears. This will create a blank slide deck you can edit. You may also create a slides presentation from the Slides homepage at slides.google.com. Here, you have the option to use a template to create your slide deck. Once you have created a slide, make sure to rename it by clicking on the default name on the top left corner of the slides interface. Next, add collaborators to work on your slides. Locate the share button on the top right corner of the slides interface and type in the names of users you want to collaborate with. The pencil icon represents Can Edit. Keep typing in the names of your collaborators and then click Send. After you create your presentation, you can choose a theme to give all your slides the same background and text styles. This will give your slide deck a consistent look and feel. You can also adjust slide layouts to change the way text and images are arranged on your slides. Add new slides to your presentation by selecting the plus button located in the upper left-hand side of the slides interface. The drop-down arrow will allow you to insert a new slide and choose the layout you prefer. The Insert menu will allow you to add objects to your slides, like text, images, shapes, and lines. To insert text, select Insert Text Box and your cursor will turn into a crosshair. Click and drag the crosshair to create a text box. Once you add words to your text box, you can format them with the formatting toolbar. Change the color of the text by highlighting it, clicking the A with an underline underneath it, and choosing a color. You can also change the fill color of the text box by selecting the Paint Bucket icon and choosing a color. To resize the text box, click on one of the 8 squares located along the edges. Drag your text box to the desired size. You can move a text box by clicking on it. Your mouse will turn into a crosshair with arrows on the end. Drag and drop your text box to its desired location. The Insert menu also allows you to insert images. After selecting Insert Image, choose how you want to bring in an image. You can upload an image that is saved on your computer or upload an image that you have in your Google Drive. You can also search Google Images directly by clicking Search, typing in a search query, selecting the image, and then clicking Select. You can resize and move images in the same manner you would a text box. There are some additional editing options available with images. You can crop an image by selecting the crop icon. A black border will appear around your image. Drag the black border inwards to crop your image. Then click anywhere on the outside of the image to apply the crop. In the image options sidebar, you can also adjust the color, transparency, brightness, and contrast of the image. Once you have multiple items on a slide, you may want to arrange them. The Arrange menu allows you to group, align, layer, and order items on your slides. To layer items, use Arrange Order to bring items to the front or send them to the back. To group or align items, select all of the items you want to group or align by holding down the Shift key and selecting all the items. Navigate to Arrange Align to automatically align your items to your desired alignment setting. Navigate to Arrange Group to stick the items together so you can move them as one piece. Once you have added content to your slides, you may want to open the Explore pane to check out the automatic layouts that Google provides. If you like one of the suggested layouts, just select it and it will be applied to your slide deck. If you don't like it, use the undo button to remove it. Once your slide deck is finished, you may need to send it to someone. To do this, navigate back to the Share button. You can type in the name of an individual user or click Get Shareable Link to generate a link you can copy and paste. Users who click the shareable link will be able to view your slides. If you need additional assistance while using Google Slides, navigate to the Help menu. Here, you can browse topics or type in a keyword to find detailed instructions.